How many of you believe that there's no greater love than Jesus laying down his life for us? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
God.
Thank you, Dorothy. Ushers, come on up and pass the baskets for the benevolence. And just so you guys know, there are needs in the house, and a lot of you have been blessed by benevolence. So this offering is for those times when people have hit a rough patch, you know, rent is due and there's no money left to pay the rent. It's those type of things. There's a group of people that get together and pray as those needs are presented, and what comes in goes out to the body. We don't keep any of it. So this is for you guys to help those in need. We've had testimonies about how you guys have been blessed. So we thank you for that in Jesus' name.
Amen. No greater love. Isn't, you know, what Jesus did for us is beyond. We couldn't conceive. If we truly conceived of what he did, we would be on our face, I think, all the time. Think about it. What he did, no greater love. Great price. And so we're going to have communion up here on the stands. We have communion trays. And just have, we say, be led by the Spirit as you come up to the stands and take the communion and participate in the price paid. Amen. And participate in your inheritance of what that price paid did for us. Amen. As we worship today. So we're going to do it during worship today. So ushers, if we could get those up on the stands so people can freely get to those. And I want to introduce our newest couple today, Luke and Natalie Shipley. Stand up. Stand up. Amen. They have been watching us live streaming. This is Lee and Luther's precious children from Florida. And they have been watching from Florida, and the Lord told them to leave everything and that God wanted them in this place. And praise God. And so God miraculously opened and transferred Natalie, and so they transferred her out here, which is amazing. So she's got a job, and so we're praying for precious Luke to get one that will be even better than before and an awesome home. And so, Father, we welcome these two in our midst, and we thank you. The long journey home. Lord, this is their second home. So, Lord, we thank you that you've united this family together. And there's a couple more in Florida, and we pray for them. And, Lord God, we just thank you for your blessing upon them. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's all stand. We're going to praise God. We're going to shout unto God. Come on, dancers, come on up here. All right, Noel, I tell you, I have to say this. We have the most awesome worship team. And I tell you what, Kat was really blessed because 2 weeks ago, Kat said that Jesus came on this platform, ushered in by the praise and worship. So praise God. Isn't that awesome? All right, Noel.
Your goodness never stops.
warm-up. You know, that was a warm-up. We haven't gone to the outer courts yet. We're right there. We're sort of limping. But we're going to jump into the river. We're going to jump into the river. Amen? We're going to jump into the river. Hallelujah. All right, Lance, go.
Yes.
Whatever it is that's stopping up the fountain of praise in us, Lord God, whatever it is, unstop it, Dorothy. That's right, unstop it. Lord, we give you permission to take the plug out, to unplug us, oh God. Unplug us, oh God. Put your hands on your tummies. For out of your bellies flows rivers of what? Living water. Lord God. Oh, Jesus. David, I feel like you're supposed to just go lay hands on people right now. Just stir them up, stir them up. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for stirring us up. Awaken us, awaken us, awaken us. Awaken us, oh God. Oh Lord, let the bubbling out, Father, and the rushing of your glory in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. Keep your arms raised, people. Come on, who's hungry and thirsty? Who is hungry and thirsty? Oh, fill us, Lord. Fill us, Lord. Father God, oh shalada, glory to your holy name, glory to your holy name. Watch out. Here comes electricity. Oh, raise your hands up. Lord, we want more. Oh, Jesus. Nigeria, and I had a chance to talk with him. He said, for hours and hours, the Nigerians will cry and scream and get emotional about the things of God. Why is it when we come into the house of God, we think we have to be quiet and subdued? This is when we should let it out the most. You go, well, you're working up the crowd. No, I'm not. I'm speaking to what's already inside of you that's crying to get out. So I say, come out, come forth in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Nigeria sees millions of people come to Christ. Why? Because they scream and they cry before the Lord. They cry before the Lord. We did 2 minutes or 3 minutes of praying out loud in tongues, and we thought, wow, that's good. How about all day and all night? Amen? Hallelujah.
The Lord wants us to begin to take Him personal. Take it personal. Take it for yourself. Don't look around and think, what does that have to do with me? The Lord said, get up close and personal with Him. Get up close and personal with the Lord this morning. This has everything to do with you. It has everything to do with you and Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. The Lord reminded me of something. He said, take communion. If you need praise and worship in your life to break out, take the broken body and the spilled blood, and you will break out of religion. You will break out of self-consciousness. You will break out of self. You will die to self. So I encourage you, don't forget about the communion up here. Whoa, Jesus. Whoa, Jesus. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice.
We rise from sin.
are just the rhythm and the sax, nothing else. Rhythm, drums, sax, go. Okay, now drums, come on in. Saw the heavenly host dispatched from heaven out to the whole world. People in Africa being blessed and touched by the praises that released heavenly activity. Wow, that's pretty awesome. Hallelujah. Glory. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. You are worthy of it all. Everything, Lord. You are worthy of it all. On this song, I implore you to seek him. I implore you to worship him. I implore you to let everything else disappear. What people think, your self-consciousness, the goofy way you might feel right now, get rid of it. He is worthy of our whole worship, our entire worship, spirit, soul, and body worship. He is worthy of it all. Amen. And if that means to bow, if it means to sit with a scarf over your head where you don't see anybody, whatever it takes, get into his presence. He's worthy of it all.
arise and shine. 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 For the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For the glory of the Lord is risen upon you.
Let's just stay quiet before the Lord right now. Just take a few minutes. Reverence the presence of a holy God. Prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare. Prepare. I hear the Lord saying, I'm coming in a way that you're not expecting. If you look at me to come as I did before, you're going to miss it through that open door.
Thank you, Lord.
There's a Kairos moment of opportunity coming.
Yes.
And if you look for me in the way that you used to look for me, you will miss it. For this is a new day. This is a new day. This is a new season. And logic and reason have no place in this new season. You will miss me if you move into logic and reason and intellectualism. You will miss it because this is fresh heaven revelation.
Very good. Very good. You know, also, too, the Lord just spoke to me. For those of you that are watching by live stream, for the Asian, for those in the Asian countries and those that are Asian, the Lord was just, there was a certain place that he was touching you, and there was something that he was awakening you, something in his, of his spirit. The Holy Spirit was stirring and stirring and stirring different things in you. There's something about when we hear sounds from our nation that the Lord begins to awaken. And I just felt really sense that the Lord was taking and touching some of those of you that are in the nations.
So, right. Father, we lift up Japan.
Yes.
We lift up Asia.
Yes.
We lift up Philippines and Thailand. We lift up China.
Yes.
We lift up Taiwan. We lift up the Asian nations, Lord God, and we speak to them freedom, a release of joy, that, Lord God, they will break off the chains of mediocrity. They will break off the chains, Lord God, of conservatism in the spirit, and they will come forth, Lord God, in freedom, in new ways of the spirit, new expressions of the spirit, new expressions in praise, new expressions in worship. And Lord, we break fear off of every one of us. Fear and intimidation to stop. It's a limitation. It's a limitation and intimidation that limits us from walking into greater and deeper lengths and depths of the Holy Ghost. So, Father God, we thank you for breaking those chains off. In Jesus' name, amen.
So be it. So be it. Thank you, Lord. Okay, Bev, we're ready.
Well, I saw a picture while we were singing, How Great is Our God.
Remember, nobody move right now. Just a minute, Beverly. I'm sorry.
It's all right.
We're preparing the way of the Lord. Nobody move.
Thank you, Jesus.
Okay, go ahead.
While we were singing, How Great is Our God, he showed me this beautiful manifestation of faith. I was walking through this meadow, and there was this huge, beautiful lion next to me, tawny and huge and big and muscular and beautiful and awesome. And we were just walking through this meadow, and there were woods on this other side, and this other lion came out of the woods, and he looked beat up and slinking, and he was just trying to move towards me, and my Lion of Judah turned and just looked at this devouring lion who was trying to come to kill, steal, and destroy. And that slinking lion just tucked his head down and went back into the woods.
So be it. Same thing happened to your enemies in this day as you were worshiping the Lord. Those of you that are watching by live streaming, that same thing took place. And that took place for your enemies. So be of good courage. He has overcome our enemies.
Right before Pastor Didi began singing about the hosts of heaven, I looked up in the clouds, and it was in the form of a white horse galloping with a warrior standing on top, and I heard the Lord say, get ready, get ready.
Very good. Here we go.
There was two things. When we were worshiping, Jesus stood right here at the bottom of the steps, and he had his hand out, and when we were worshiping him, we didn't realize that he was standing right here and he was receiving it all with his hands out. And he was just looking at everybody, and I was hoping that everybody else could see him too. So instead of worshiping like this, we could look him right in the eye to worship. And the Holy Spirit kept coming around like a whirlwind. He just kept whizzing around like a whirlwind.
So on a horse and a whirlwind. That's awesome. Yeah. Very good. Very good. All right. Well, praise God. Praise God. Thank you, worship team. That was awesome. Yeah, that was really awesome. Did you have something good?
I saw Jesus standing there.
Okay. Okay. Here, this is one more. This is really cool.
I saw Jesus also standing with his arms open, but I also saw the table was set in front of us. And 4 weeks ago during worship, I had seen
no walking people right
a
now,
forest.
Please.
And the forest was really thick, and I wondered what was hiding in there. But it was very plush green, and we were standing on this side of it. There it was. So as we stepped in obedience, a path opened up, and the path was light, and at the end of it was light. And I knew as we walked through there in obedience that mysteries were being revealed, and we had a lot to do with being a part of that mystery that God was revealing to us.
Very good. That was.
All right, now you can all walk.
Yes.
We're learning, aren't we? We're preparing the way of the Lord. Because I tell you what, when he came, I tell you,